Welcome everybody, my name is François Letarte and this is my channel JDR D30, a channel about tabletop role-playing games. Today I'm going to do a review of a game that I really love. It's very special for me. It's the game I'm running right now with my group, and it was quite a discovery for me in recent years. So what is this game? This game is Advanced Fighting Fantasy. After that you have the magic part. I really like this magic system. It's quite simple. Personally, in general I have problems with magic systems in role-playing games. I don't know why, but I have hard time to manage that. The only magic system I could really handle is Dungeons and Dragons. For me it was quite simple. Here you have three types of magic that are shown here. The first one is minor magic. It's kind of the cantrip, which are really easy to cast. The wizardry, which are for magic users. You take magic points to cast your spell, and it's an unopposed test. Your target may use luck to resist the spell if the spell allows it. It's really simple. It's kind of the BRP system. Instead of percentile, well, it's 2d6. 2d6. I don't know how to say it. Maybe you can correct me in the comments. And there's also the sorcery, which was introduced in the sorcery series. And instead of taking magic point to cast, it takes stamina points to cast. But these are very powerful spell. I have a sorcerer in my group, and it's very interesting. He casts very these are badass spells. It blasts, but he weakens very rapidly. So you have to be careful when you have a sorcerer. It's very interesting as a class. Well, I say a class, it's kind of a proficiency, something you do in your life. Religion. Religion is a big part of the fighting fantasy world. I really like the way it's presented here. The priest only have a few powers, like four powers, granted by their gods. These are very efficient powers, but the powers represent the god's will. And the guidelines here tells you that you have to act in accordance to what your gods want. And if you don't do that, well, you may lose your powers. Since they're not much powers and the gods are really well described here, it's easy to put in the story. It's easy to keep an eye on the priest to see how he does his thing. And I have a priest in my group, and he plays it very well. I never had such a religious character which was really in tune with the setting, and it's very great. After the magic, you have some monsters presented here if you want to try to begin the game. There's not much, because there's another book with the kind of the monster manual of the Advanced Fighting Fantasy since Out of the Pit. Strangely, Out of the Pit is an incomplete book. I will make a review of this book later, which will explain why. But it's incomplete, and here you have the complete list of what is missing from the other book. So if you want to have a monster here, you want to have everything he can do, you have to get these two books together. It's manageable, and if you don't have both books, the game is so easy that you can just go with what you know from the monsters and play it like you think he will be played, and it works very well. In my next adventure, I have created a monster, and it's just in my imagination. I didn't wrote any numbers. I just know that when he'll show up, it will be well played, because I exactly know what he's about. And I doesn't need to roll stats in advance. You can fudge things to that point. What else? Well, magic items and some optional rules. There are many options in that game. That game is not perfect in a sense that well, it's a kind of an old school game, but it's well done for the modern times as we live. It's not perfect because there are some mistakes in the game, but the mistakes, the game is so easy that sometimes you have a rule in some places in the book and you have the same rule repeated elsewhere, and that tells you to completely that the rule is completely opposed to, from each other. But for me, it's just like you have two options to interpret that rules. So for me, it's fine that the game is so rules light that it doesn't matter. You take what you want and you play it. That game. Why I came with that game? Because I was searching for this kind of game for a very long time. I was searching for a game that was just a little old school in the feel, that was really simple, and that has a personality. I had in mind to play basic Dungeons and Dragons, and I even tried some games. It was fun, but that game is so broken that it's good, but it's kind of broken. Sometimes the rules doesn't fit together, and I wasn't that much satisfied with that. It's so simple, and it has that personality. It has that flavor, and I never thought that this game would satisfy my needs of having simple, with personality, and with that small old school feel. It has all that in Advanced Fighting Fantasy, and it will survive the future. You can have campaigns, satisfying campaigns for a long time with that. My players are veteran players. We have decades of experience in role-playing games. We've played them all, from Rollmaster to Call of Cthulhu, Vampire, Dungeons and Dragons, every one of them. We know the systems, we've tried them all, and we do really enjoy that game. It's very good. We can see the potential of how far we can go with that game. And the setting is cool. The setting of the game, Fighting Fantasy game books are really cool. We have space to create a lot of thing in that. What else can I say? Well, firstly, I hope that I've opened your curiosity about that game. You can check out the Drive-Thru RPG free quick start. Also, you can well, flip the book at your game store if you have it. It's not a very expensive book in itself. And the game, the publisher Orion Games is going quite well with the game. They have lots of supplement out, and many are on the way. We have, the core book. I've shown you Out of the Pit for the monsters. We have Titan, which is kind of the world of Advanced Fighting Fantasy. We have Heroes Companion, some more rules to create your heroes, and some more rules about the mass battles, creating a wilderness environment. It's quite useful. We have Crown of Kings, which is a campaign. It's the sorcery books campaign. That's it. And I will play it sometime. I've just received it this week. Black Sand, the infamous city. The city that was in the book, the game book, City of Thieves. Very good. With some more rules about some aspects like gunpowder and stuff like that. And the last one, Sorcery Spellbook. All the spells a sorcerer can have. And it's a nice prop. It's a nice book with well illustrated, with an old school feel. And everything that he needs to know is in that, with some optional rules. That video has taken long enough. I will do some walkthrough about that game later. That game will follow me for a long time. And I hope, well, I hope you know more about that game. You will, and well, hope you'll check it out because it really worth it. So, up to next time, my name is François Le Tarte at JDRD30, and have fun in your game, as in life. So, see you next time. Where's the 30? Where's the 30? 30, 30, 30 here.